away, you stupid rabbit. Let's go and check good old ePortal. Oh, an email from Julie.
Remind me again why we're coming to Chemistry Drop-In.
Because we have this stupid film to do for chemistry, and I don't care.
Why am I here?
Because you're going to help me make it. Now come on, let's go in.
I hate science. It always smells of beetroot.
Oh, come on! Hi, sir. You said we could come and ask you about this chemistry film.
We? I don't know when I got dragged into
this. Oh, shush!
Ah, yes, I remember. You have to research the scientist, don't you? Well, if you want, I'll give you a bit of background history. Well, it all started with John Dalton, who was born in 1766. And is best known for his pioneering work with... Oh, that's my net gone! Roll the film!
John Dalton was born into a Quaker family in 1766. He is famous for his research into the modern atomic theory and also his studies into colour blindness.
Being blind to colour isn't easy, but I don't let it affect my life. Last night I went to see Joseph and his amazing brown coat.
He came up with a very important atomic theory. This stated that all atoms of the same element were identical and that elements could be classed by their atomic weights.
All matter is made up of particles called atoms, which cannot be made or destroyed. Different elements have different types of atoms. When an element combines, the atoms don't change in themselves, they just change the way they're grouped. A chemical reaction occurs when the atoms regroup.
He also devised the three laws of multiple proportions, which are still a major tool in chemical measurements. This and the atomic theory is still used today, having been changed a little bit. However, his ideas about colour blindness were never given credence.
I'm not bothered that my report into colour blindness was ignored. I just want people to know that being blind to colour isn't easy. I can't tell red from blue. I once tottered into a brothel thinking it was a police station.
So all atoms of a given element are identical. Look here. All atoms of any element on this periodic table will be identical. Hydrogen, for example, will have one proton and one electron.
But sir, if you have an isotope of...
My nose!
I'm sorry, Sarah.
Are you alright?
Yeah, I'll be fine.
Well, we better roll the next bit of film. Go, go, go!
Is it bleeding?
I think so. There's some red around your mouth.
Well, that's just jam for my sandwich at lunch.
I had trout for lunch.
Lovely, that's good, that.
J.J. Thomson is most famous for his discovery of the electron, and also his invention of the mass spectrometer. His dad sadly passed away when he was young, so was unable to see him grow up and watch him progress to Cambridge University.
Hello! I discovered the electron through the experiments with cathode rays. I proved that the ray is made up of lots of little negatively charged particles. These little electrons are tiny. Bless them! After doing this, I also proved that hydrogen atoms only have one electron. Some previous scientists have suggested that there were varying amounts. Shows what they know, I suppose.
J.J. Thomson also discovered isotopes when he was looking at the nature of canal rays. He noticed when firing ionized neon beams through an electric and magnetic field there were two distinct patches of light, suggesting two different parabolas of deflection. This led to the conclusion that there must be two different masses of neon.
This is the first example of mass spectrometry, and I discovered it! I then got some of my students to improve it and develop it into a method which is used today. But the credit should go to me. After all, I am J.J. Thomson. I also discovered the natural reactivity of potassium. Gosh, is there anything I haven't done?
Thomson also put forward the idea of the plum pudding model of the atom, where there is a large positive cloud and the electrons are like the moving plums in the pudding.
So that was J.J. Thomson.
He's a bit cocky, isn't he? Well, wouldn't you be if you discovered that much about modern science?
I suppose so.
So what's this about toffee pudding?
You mean plum pudding? Well, basically he suggested that atoms were spheres of positive charge, with little bits of negative charge floating around in it.
But that's wrong! Surely Dr. Donnelly told us that the positive charge is at the centre of the atom.
And the electrons orbited around the outside. This J.J. Thomson didn't know much when you think about it.
Well, the modern model of the atom was invented by the next scientist, Ernest Rutherford.
Whoa, exciting.
Oh, get a laugh.
That was totally inappropriate.
Yeah, first you hit me in the face, now this!
Sorry, Sarah.
Roll the next film!
Ernest Rutherford is the most famous scientist of the four. He left such a legacy he even had his own coat of arms. His discoveries about the structure of an atom were very important.
My experiment was very simple. I fired alpha particles into a sheet of gold. On the opposite side of the gold foil to the alpha source, there was a detector, which flashed when hit by an alpha particle.
The experiment was carried out by his students, who at one point had almost given up on the whole experiment before Ernest said to them,
I told them to move the detector to the same side of the foil as the alpha source. Shockingly, some of the particles bounced back. This led me to the conclusion that atoms have a very dense, positively charged nucleus, which repels the positive alpha particles.
As well as some particles being scattered back, some went through, showing that atoms are mainly composed of empty space.
Basically, I've discovered the basis of all modern chemistry and nuclear physics.
The things you can do with gold and then you fire particles at it.
What would you use a sheet of gold for?
Draft excluder. Gets pretty nippy in my room in winter.
But you understand what he did?
He basically fired a radioactive gun at some gold and then some particles bounced back.
This showed his dense nature.
No, showed that atoms have a dense central nucleus.
Which has a positive charge.
The rest of the atom is composed of empty space, which was proven as most of the alpha particles went through.
Fantastic. If I could be bothered, I would give you an achievement slip. As it is, here's a stick of celery and a 2-for-1 voucher for local cash and carry.
Thanks.
I like celery, and I need that voucher. We're all out of bourbons. And also, I could buy that and the new Lady Gaga album, Avogadro.
I think you'll find it's Alejandro.
Ready to see the final film?
Go for it, Steve-O!
Roll on the next film.
Henry Moseley studied at Oxford University. He then went on to work with Ernest Rutherford in Manchester. Whilst at Manchester, he made a discovery.
I found a systematic relation between wavelength and atomic number. I did this by using the X-ray electromagnetic spectrum. I called this Moseley's Law, after myself.
Before this discovery, the elements in the periodic table were ordered by mass.
By doing this, I found gaps in the periodic table. There must be elements that haven't been discovered.
These gaps were filled by four elements which were discovered after Moseley's death in the First World War. He was killed at the age of 27, and from then on, no prominent or promising scientist has been allowed to go into battle.
So now you know all you need.
We just need to make a film now.
I've got an idea. And then, at the end, we're singing Respect by Aretha Franklin.
That's a great idea, but I don't get how a mezuzah would be useful.
Anyway, I'd best be off. I've got to go to the doctors for an inspection of my jejunum.
Thanks, Steve-O!
Thanks for all your help!
Bye!